guys, it's PokeGirl7 here, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the best Generation 5 Pokemon in Pokemon Go. So the first wave of Gen 5 is going to be released in September, and a lot of my subscribers tell me that they don't know much about the Generation 5 Pokemon. So in today's video, we're going to talk about which of these Pokemon are the best from that region, which Pokemon are more worth your while for powering up and getting candies for, so let's go ahead and jump into it. I do want to say before we start this video that this list isn't really in any particular order. I'm kind of just going off of these Pokemon's individual stats and that sort of thing. And I'm not going to be including any legendary or mythical Pokemon in this list. I'm thinking about doing another video where I rank the Gen 5 mythicals and legendaries. And those probably aren't coming out for a little while anyways, or at least not for the next couple of months. So I think I'm just going to focus on non-legendary and non-mythical Pokemon. And like I said, it's not in any specific order. I'm just kind of going off the top of my head like the best ones that I can think of from this region. So first off, we have Chandelure. Chandelure is a ghost and fire type Pokemon that evolves from Lampent. It has a maximum CP of 3268, a very high attack of 271, a great defense of 182, and an average stamina of 155. Chandelure could become the best non-legendary ghost type attacker in Pokemon Go if it is given good ghost moves. Chandelure could potentially replace Gengar and be second only to Giratina. And next up we have Archaeops. Archaeops is a rock and flying type Pokemon that evolves from Arcan. It has a max CP of 3331 and it has a very high attack stat of 292. Keep in mind Mewtwo has an attack stat of 300, so this is almost the same attack stat as Mewtwo, which is known as being like one of the best attackers, if not the best attacker. Archaeops has a slightly average defense of 139 and a pretty good stamina of 181. With good rock type moves, it will be a better rock type attacker than Tyranitar. It doesn't have the same stamina as Tyranitar, but it will be a better attacker, which could be good in some cases. Next up we have Excadrill. Excadrill is a ground and steel type Pokemon that evolves from Drillbur. It has a max CP of 3244, a high attack stat of 255, a very low defense of 129, and a high stamina of 242. Excadrill's typing gives it a lot of resistances, so it's not really the best ground type in the game and not really the best steel type, but the fact that it has so many resistances gives it a little bit of an advantage. Next up we have Conkeldurr. Conkeldurr evolves from Girder and it is a fighting type Pokemon. It has a maximum CP of 3337, a high attack stat of 243, a slightly average defense of 158, and a high stamina of 233. So this Pokemon has a higher attack and stamina than Machamp and the exact same defense as Machamp. So overall, it does replace Machamp as the best fighting type attacker if it is given counter and dynamic punch. So fingers crossed on this one. And next up, we have one of my personal favorites, Haxorus. Haxorus is a dragon type Pokemon that evolves from Fracture. It has a max CP of 3593, a very high attack stat of 284, which is the exact same as Rayquaza. It has a pretty average defense stat of 172, which is actually very similar to Rayquaza as well. I think Rayquaza's defense stat is 170. And then it has a pretty decent stamina stat of 183, which is much lower than Rayquaza. So overall, it would be the best non-legendary dragon type attacker in the game, especially if it's given good dragon type moves. And then we have Krookodile. Krookodile is a ground and dark type Pokemon that evolves from Krokorok. It has a max CP of 2929 and has a pretty good attack of 229, an average defense of 145, and a great stamina of 216. It doesn't really replace any ground or dark types, but it's still a great Pokemon overall. And next up we have Hydreigon. Hydreigon evolves from Zweilous and it's a dark and dragon type Pokemon. It has a max CP of 3625, a high attack stat of 256, a great defense stat of 188, and great stamina of 211. It's very comparable to Salamence and Garchomp on the dragon type level. And then we have Braviary, who happens to be our normal and flying type of this region, and it evolves from Rufflet. It has a max CP of 3088, a high attack stat of 232, an average defense stat of 152, and a high stamina of 225. And it can be compared to Staraptor, but it has a slightly higher stamina. Next up is Darmanitan. Darmanitan is a fire type Pokemon that evolves from Darumaka. It has a maximum CP of 3105, a very high attack of 263, a low defense of 114, and a high stamina of 233. If this Pokemon is given good fire type moves, it'll actually be the second best fire attacker in the game. Next up is Runicless. Runicless is a psychic type Pokemon that evolves from Duosion. It has a max CP of 2927, a great attack of 214, an average defense of 148, and a high stamina of 242. And then we have Gigalith. Gigalith is a rock type Pokemon that evolves from Bulldoor. Its max CP is 3175, it has a great attack of 226, a great defense of 194, and a great stamina of 198. So this Pokemon has very balanced stats. It can definitely be compared to Golem as a rock type Pokemon. And next up we have Golurk. Golurk is a ground and ghost type Pokemon. It evolves from Golett and it has a maximum CP of 2854. It has a great attack stat of 222, an average defense of 154, and a great stamina of 205. Golurk won't necessarily replace any ghost or ground type Pokemon, but it's still a great choice overall. And last but not least, we have Bisharp. Bisharp is a dark and steel type Pokemon that evolves from Poniard. It has a maximum CP of 2844, a great attack of 232, a good defense of 176, and an average stamina of 163. It's not really the best steel or dark type Pokemon, but it's still good enough. And those are the best non-legendary and non-mythical Pokemon from the Unova region, which is Generation 5. So guys, I'm so excited for this region to come out in Pokemon Go. It's gonna be so much fun. I'm personally more excited for the Halloween event this year because I really think we're gonna be getting those Gen 5 ghost type Pokemon. And I'm gonna be getting my Litwick, which eventually evolves into Chandelure, which we did talk about in this video. I'm so excited for that Pokemon and just all of these Pokemon overall. I think I have 13 on my list today. So I guess let me know in the comments down below if I left anything out in that 13. I think I covered most of the ones that weren't legendary or mythical, but let me know. Okay guys, so that concludes the best Generation 5 Pokemon list, but I do have something to tell you guys before I go. So at the time that you're watching this video, I am at the beach. I took a personal family vacation. I wanted to get away for a little while, so if you don't see many uploads coming up soon, it's just because I'm gone and I decided to go on a trip for once where I wasn't really making videos, because a lot of times I do travel and go on amazing trips, but I'm usually, you know, filming vlogs the whole time. I'm never really present in the moment, so I thought this would be a good, like, actual vacation. So you probably won't see very much footage from my vacation just because it's supposed to be a time for me to chill out and enjoy the moment. So I just want to let you guys know that if uploads are a little bit sparse for the next week, just keep that in mind. It is going to be a 5-day trip, so I'm not really sure how I'm going to do it. I think I'm going to post this video while I'm at the beach, and I think I'm gonna have like one more. So out of 5 days, I'm gonna be posting like 2 times, which normally I post every single day. So I just wanted to give you guys a heads up on all of that. But yeah, wish me luck on that trip because it's been a while since I've been on an actual vacation like this and haven't really worked on it. So it's gonna feel kind of weird not working for 5 days straight, but I can't wait. But anyways guys, I guess that's all for today's video. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comments down below which Generation 5 Pokemon you are most excited for, and I guess I'm gonna go ahead and close off this video right here. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure you smash that like button, hit subscribe if you're new to the channel to join my Gengar gang, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye.